वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमित श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नितानंदसहोदित श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समयुक्त बिंदावन मनोहर वांशाकल्पतरुवश्च कृपा सिंधुवश्च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधवं वृंदावई तुलसीदेव वै पिया वै केशवस्वच कृष्णभक्तिपदे देवी सत्वत्वै नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरये संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेशे गौरीय पत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरुभक्तियुक्त भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्वरुण्य धैयम् सदा परिभवन्मविष्टदूहम् तीर्थास्पदम् शिव विरंचिनुतम् शरण्यम् भीतातिहम् पनुतपालभवद्विपूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमनिच्छटाय विस्फुरजीत किमपि गपवधूष्वदर्श पूर्णानुरागरस सागर सारमूर्ति साराधिका मयि कदा कृपां करोषि श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावदत् संकीर्तनैकपितरो कमलायताक्ष विशाम्बरो द्विजवरो जुगधर्मपालो वंदे जगत्प्रियकरो करुणावतारो हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरीनिरन्तरविभूषितवामभागं नारायणो प्रियमनङ्गमदापहारं वाराणसीपुरपति भजवीशनाथं वागीशजुष्व वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्व च वक्षसि जस्यास्ति हृदये संविः त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। जय यस्यास्ति भक्तिर्भगवती यकिंचना सर्वगुणैस्तत्रो शमाशते सुरः हरो अभक्तस्य कुतो महद्गुण मनोरथेन सतो धवतो हि यस्यास्ति भक्तिर्भगवती यकिंचना सर्वगुणैस्तत्र शमाशते सुरः हरो अभक्तस्य कुतो महद्गुण मनोरथेन सतो धवतो वही। गौरीय गोष्ठीपति श्री श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड दैट गौर की वस्तु वार ए यूनिक थिंग गौरांग महाप्रभु इज। To understand this point, you will have to avoid all, cut all evil association. You will have to take resolution in your life that I can cut all asasanga. Gaur ki vastu, what an excellent thing Gauranga Mahaprabhu is. To realize this point, you must avoid all asasanga first, evil association. But bonded soul, they cannot understand what is sasanga, asasanga. Knowingly or unknowingly, somehow they are doing asasanga. Those who are not totally established in Advaita Gyantattva, those who are, I was bound to speak in front of big sabha, a mammoth gathering was there. I was speaking in front of big, you know, sadhu. That until and unless a sadhu is totally established in Advaita Gyantattva, he cannot go for preaching. He should not go for preaching. I can give all evidence from the writings of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, everything. Because Advaita Gyantattva, if I am not established, then dual conception can come and disturb me, my Shuddha Darshan. I cannot have pure Darshan because I am not situated unto the lotus feet of Sadguru. In that case, I cannot go for preaching because actually it is not possible for bonded soul to avoid asasanga totally, not possible. Yes, it is possible when they are 100% inclined unto the lotus feet of Sadguru, enjoying full kripa of Guru Vaishnava, then 100% they can grow that kind of sensitivity, that kind of sensitivity, that kind of eyes, through which they can detect this is asasanga. Very nice harikatha going on, very nice. But still they can understand it is not actually harikatha. But for that, to grow that kind of sensitivity, you must enjoy full kripa of Guru Vaishnava. Otherwise, you cannot understand. Because bonded soul always busy with Sangha. Without Sangha, nobody can live. And Prabhupada used to say, somebody speaking, Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, Paramahansa Acharya Varjo told to Prabhupada not to go to Kalir Brahmanda, not to go for any bad association, any other association. Babaji Maharaj told. Prabhupada speaking, Prabhupada giving answer, that actually believe me, I am going to Aprakito courtyard of Gauriya Math Vrindavan. I am not going to Calcutta, Kalir Brahmanda. I am not going to get any association, bad association, because the kind of excellent association I have received by the mercy of my Guru Maharaj, my Guru Path Padma Paramahansa Sesha Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj, he has given me such a highest, you know, association, highest, you know, association, so unique association. After that, I After that, I cannot feel any taste to take an association. After that, I cannot get any taste. If you allow me to take any association, I am not getting any taste. How I can get association? Association means you should have some attachment. Otherwise, association, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, totally speaking, Sangha, if there is no asakti, no attachment, then Sangha is not, you know. Sangu jo sangsatere hetuho asasya vihito dhiya sa evo sadusu kritaha mokshadaram apavritam. I told Kapilji Maharaj speaking too. I am speaking one line from two sloka different, but it looks nice. So, Prabhupada speaking, I am not feeling any taste. The kind of Sangha I already received by the mercy of my Gurupath Padma Paramahansa Sesto Sri Gaurakshadas Bhavaji Maharaj. How I can feel taste? Material association not possible? This should be our mood. This should be our bhav. Prabhupada teaching us, when we are going to get the association of pure Guru Vaishnava, even then, if we are getting some, even then, after that, if we are going to feel some attraction from material thing, then surely your Sangha is not pure Sangha. You have not done any pure Sangha. Satsangha not done by. So, this is not a matter of fighting. Today we are going to discuss about what Prabhupada wanted to say about Acharya Sip. Very sensitive point. So many devotees from different parts of the world sending question. If I cannot give answer, then my previous answer, maybe you can think it is not clear. That's why I am bound to speak. But please excuse me, this is so sensitive issue. If I go on speaking all in details, then you can think that I am going to criticize. But believe me, I can feel directly that I am going to leave my body. I can see from now. Very clearly I can see I am going to leave my body. So how it is possible for me to fight with somebody? How it is possible for me to express false ego? Is it possible? By the mercy of Prabhupada, by the mercy of Guru Varga, I can see clearly I am going to leave my body. So it is not possible for me to fight with anybody. But to give a clear answer, I must speak all in details. Actually, you know, many times I told that Atah Krishna Namadi no bhavet grajyam indriye sevan mukhe hi yuhaya madho swayameva spurt ada. How you can understand this point? Atah Krishna Namadi no bhavet grajyam indriye. Krishna Nam and Krishna are the same. And Krishna and Krishna Nam is there in transcendental plane. How in bonded condition I can chant Krishna Nam and sing, I can sing about Krishna. If I am not elevated up to that point, how I can speak about them? Aprakito vastu kobhu prakito gochar noy. Aprakito vastu, the transcendental, you know, things, you know, you cannot touch, you cannot feel about the transcendental thing if you are in bonded condition. First of all, we should understand. It is my request to you all, unto your lotus feet, your everybody, that don't try to think I am going to criticize. Is a very sensitive point. Is a question of our life and death. Is a question, very sensitive point, because it is not a, you know, It is not a point on which we can fight. It's a question of our survival in the way of this in the spiritual field. It's a question of our survival in the way of the spiritual field. How I can fight on this sensitive issue? Only I can do one thing. I can quote what Prabhupada told, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, what is spoken by Baladeva Buddhavasan, what is spoken by Jiva Goswami, but that much I can do. A genuine messenger of Supreme Lord. A genuine messenger of Supreme Lord can never misguide you. You will have to remember the third sloka of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If you have no smell of personal pratishtha, many times before I already discussed on these points, on those points, then and only then you can sing the glory of Supreme Lord. Then and only then you can sing the glories of Supreme Lord if you are established in Trinadavi Slok. Otherwise, Aprakita Harinam, Harikatha cannot come, cannot dance on your tongue. Not possible. It is not possible. Because Krishna's Hari name, form, qualities and pastimes are all on the absolute platform. Material senses cannot touch them. Not possible. When conditioned soul is awakened to Krishna consciousness and try to do seva from heart under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava, then and only then he can get revealed all about that absolute truth inside his heart. Otherwise, you can have proficiency. You have so much, you know, you maybe you are erudite scholar, but still you cannot realize this absolute truth, anything about that absolute truth, not possible. You know, I was bound to start with this sloka, this last sloka from Srimad Bhagavatam, Jasyasti Bhaktir Bhagavati Akinchana. This is a very vital point. There is no Akinchana Bhakti. But still somebody going to act as an acharya. Impossible. Yasyasi bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarva gunis tatru shamasati suraha. If there is akinchana bhakti inside your heart, akinchana bhakti means the only property given by my Guru Pad Padma is Krishna, lotus feet of Gauranga. Follow. Even Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking that I am Akinchan, Niskinchan, and you can laugh. You are a Niskinchan? How possible? Infinity Brahmanda, you are controlling everything yours. No, Krishna is saying nothing. Aham Niskinchana Niskinchana Janair Priya. Krishna speaking, even to Rukmini Devi, I am Niskinchan. And those who are Niskinchan, actually they can love me from heart. Then how is Niskinchan? Well, yes, because my only property is the lotus feet of Radharani. You can go mad after hearing this Siddhanta. But if you are actually Gauriya devotee, if you are following Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you should not go mad. You should understand this point. Why Krishna speaking this? Krishna Niskinchan speaking himself, I am Niskinchan. How is possible? How we can believe? 100%. Because Krishna thinking, I have no property. The only property I have is the lotus feet of Radharani. That is the point. So, Jasasti Bhakti Bhagavati Akinchana, Akinchana Bhakti, it is quite natural that all demigods and everything, everybody can stay inside the heart of that devotee. Sarvaguna is tatro shama sati suraha. Haru abhapta sakuto mahat gunaha. How we can expect nice and transcendental qualities inside the heart of those material people, those who are running from love, puja, patishta, everything. I discussed everything before. You should remember, it is my request. All I discussed before. Material patishta, Prabhupada comparing with the stool of a pig, boar. But Vaishnavi patishta is totally exclusive. Also, I like to give you a reminder, many times before I told about Ekayan Pantha. Whereas the unique procedure, one and single procedure through each Veda, Upanishad, swaying ultimately Ekayan Pantha. Who can believe Ekayan Pantha? And who cannot believe? Those who are actually devotees, actual devotees, they can believe Ekayan Pantha, Bhava Pantha, going to believe on their own capacity, own power. They are actually materialistic idea. They can go with this conception. They can do anything. They can recite Bhagavatam. Very nicely, they can speak with music. Those idiots, they are running with musical instrument, everything like idiot, like pros, to earn money, position. Are Maharaj, you can never get Vaishnavi Pratishtha. You can fight whole life. You can never get Vaishnavi Pratishtha because you have done aparadh unto a lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava. That is why you cannot get Vaishnavi Pratishtha, impossible for you. If you can understand Vaishnavi Pratishtha, then automatically, you can become humbler than the blade of grass. It's an automatic factor. It is not a matter of practice. I can practice how to become. Asasanga going on, or at the same time I am practicing how to become Trinathapi. It's infinity period, not possible. Infinity period, the whole world learning for, the whole world running for love, puja, pratishtha, everything. But a pure sadhu is always having clear idea about this is bondage and this is tattvajnan. This is bondage. This way if I go, I can get some simply bondage. And this is called tattvajnan. And tattvajnan, you cannot, it's not a matter of material education. You have material education, you have very nice brain. So you can, memorize all points. Okay, you can memorize, but you cannot feel. It is not that you can understand everything. That is why Gaurakishore Bhaji Maharaj told, okay, they can recite Rasa Leela everything, but where from they can get realization? Realization is there in the hand of pure Guru Vaishnava. At all, if they want to give you, you can get, or if they want to cheat you, you can get cheated. You cannot get. They can give, they cannot give. Many times I told, before also I discussed, Snigdosya Shishyasya Gurava Gujyam Api Uto. Whom Gurudev can speak all the secrets of bhajan? Whom? Those were sober, actually Snigdosya Shishya. Snigdosya Shishya means who is totally unified with the heart of Guru Pad Padma, totally harmonized. There is no 0.00001% disparity, nothing there. Totally dovetailed. In that case, Guru Pad Padma can realize, Guru Pad Padma can realize your heart, and then Guru Pad Padma can give transfer all everything, all the secrecy of bhajan. You can realize gradually. Even Guru Pad Padma going away from this, so no, it matters little. Guru Pad Padma is there physically or not. But anyway, Sadguru, Satsishya always feeling that Guru Pad Padma is always there sitting with him inside his heart. Non-stop Guru Puja going on inside the heart of a pure devotees, pure Shishya. Inside the heart of a pure disciple, continuous and non-stop Guru Puja going on. Not that Abhirbhav Tithi can come and I can worship Gurupatma, not that. Continue non-stop. And many times I told before, Snigdha Sishya, enjoying full Kripa of Gurupada Padma, Sadguru. Like I can give example of Madhavendu Puripad and Ishwar Puripad. Though he, you know, total Kripa, not 1% less, total Kripa. Gaurakishat Babaji Maharaj Prabhupada, total Kripa. You know, though eternal person, still there is an ideal example I can set in front of you all. So there is not even 0.10% disparity, totally. So in that case, automatically, if you are going to follow Sadguru, doing seva from heart, non-stop seva, automatically, you can get full kripa from Guru Vaishnava. You can get automatically, you can get full kripa. And many times I told, this is the actual Siddhanta. If you are Satsisya, if you are Satsisya, Snigdha Sishya, 100% you are Guru. If you are Snigdha Sishya, if you are Satsisya and you are not Guru, it's not possible. If you are Satsisya, Satsisya means through Seva, through Guru Seva, through continuous Guru Seva, through continuous non-stop Guru Seva, unique Guru Seva, is bound to get the post of Gurupad Padma. Because he is not a cheater. In the name of Guru Seva, in the name of Guru Bhajan, we are doing all rubbish. I would request you to go through an article written by me long ago, all with all reference. It was published in Devananda Goswami. So many articles published in different places. But one by one, I forget everything. So I would request you to go through Guru Sevak Hoy Manno Je Amar. Guru Sevak Hoy Manno Je Amar. This the Sevak of Guru is honorable to me, 100%. I cannot ignore him. But if he is not going to show total idealism shown by Guru Padma, he is totally deviated, then he cannot expect, you know, that kind of honor. It's not possible. So long as one Acharya is going to follow his Guru Padma 100%, 100%, whole life, then in that case, is possible. You know, it's called eternal Acharyasi. That's why Prabhupada many times wanted to speak, but we are so foolish. Our heart is full of argument. We don't understand what Prabhupada wants to say. We never try to understand what Prabhupada wanted. Prabhupada always wanted to say about eternal Acharyaship. If eternal Acharyaship is not there, temporary Acharyaship, suppose through election or an election or through some procedure, you know, somebody is Acharya. He is going to follow his Guru Padma maybe for 6 months or 1 year. After clearly, if you are not foolish, you can understand he is totally deviated from the track of Guru Padma. Totally. And whereas Prabhupada already told many times I discussed before, the slightest deviation from the track of your Guru Padma can throw you away from bhajan. So how we can expect acharyasi from him? This is the main point. What is the criteria? How you can understand what is genuine, what is not genuine? How to understand? First of all, it is a Siddhanta. First of all, you should grow genuinity first. If you are yourself not going to grow genuinity inside your heart, never infinity pure you can understand who is genuine or not. First of all, sincerity should be there, genuinity should be there, then 100% you are going to get, enjoy divine help. 100%. If you are not kapat, no kapat bab is there, no duplicity, nothing. Baladev Abhirbhav Tithi coming, I can discuss all in detail. I can discuss all in detail. because I by the mercy of Prabhupada I believe that Gurudev coming from the transcendental world of Prakita Jagat, Balaji Maharaj coming, I can discuss this point. But if you are going to force me, if you are going to put pressure on me, if you are going to put pressure on me not to believe this point, then better you can kill me. I am not going to lose this belief, 100% belief. If I am going to lose this, you know, Siddhanta, this belief, then what is the utility of my life, bhajan life? Why should I live? I should die. I should die. What I can do? Mahaprabhu crying and speaking. What I can do with this useless life? What I can do with this useless life, whereas Krishna bhajan I cannot understand, Guru Tattva I cannot understand, whereas in my life already I have received kick about Guru Tattva, false Guru Tattva, so many, you know, fall down in my life, this Guru, still today I cannot understand. I can understand when I am 100% sincere. When I am 100% without any duplicity, if I try to understand this point, automatically. Yatha yatha atma parimijyati aso matpunna gatha savano vidhanai. I already told this sloka many times. The more you are going to hear Harikatha from pure Guru Vaishnava, genuine, from heart you will have to hear. Not that you can hear something from here, not that's a duplicity there, here, something from that market. Then I cannot. Guru Padma cannot take my responsibility. If I am not 100% inclined, then Guru Padma, how Guru Padma can take my responsibility? How it is possible for him to take my responsibility? Acharya is self-manifesting personality. An Acharya can never be elected by voting system. Why and how Prabhupada wanted to speak? Why? We should understand this point. If we misunderstand Prabhupada, then his great problem can be there. First of all, try to realize that Guru Tattva, you should realize Guru Tattva from heart first. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already, in Chaitanya Chaitamitu we find, who is Guru? Who can act as Guru? Mahaprabhu, it is a description, it is a instruction of Mahaprabhu. Kiva vipro kiva nashi shudra kene noy, jai Krishna tattva betta sei Guru hoy. So you can realize this point? Kiva vipro, he is vipro, or sannyasi, or from a high, you know, class family, you know, what is concerned to us? We are interested about pure devotional practice. Through Harikatha, we will have to stop all cheating. Preaching can go, but in the name of preaching, cheating cannot be done. We will have to make a big association all over the world, under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, to stop all cheating. Preaching can go. Who is going to stop preaching? Can allow preaching. But what should be the criteria? What would be the qualities of a preacher? What is the quality of a guru? All Siddhanta Vichar should be there inside my heart. So, it matters little that I am Brahman, I am high class, you know, Brahman from high family. Those who are pasanda, those who are, you know, heartless, even they are going to speak, I am from high family, higher than the family of Guru Padma, heritage of Guru Padma. This, they are heartless. They are going to die in hell. No. So, kiva vipro kiva nashi shudra kene noy jei krishna tattva betta sei guru hoy. Ramananda is topmost guru. Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj topmost guru. Raghunath Das Gosai is topmost guru. When there is somebody, some, you know, out of false ego, you know, wanted to pass this kind of remark in front of Prabhupada, that Raghunath Das Goswami was from low caste actually, that's why he used to pay dandavat to our previous, you know, father, forefather used to pay dandavat. Then Prabhupada started fasting, without water, without, you know, any prasadam. Prabhupada speaking, how is possible that I hear this thing from that, you know, from that man. So I like to die. After that, that man was bound to come in front of Prabhupada and beg for pardon. We cannot pass this kind of remark. Each and every time Bhagavan going to provide a kick through Mayadevi. But still I cannot handle. Many times insulted in a preaching field, many times so many disgusted things happen, but still I am going for preaching. To earn name and pen. So first of all, now we will have to understand why Prabhupada wanted to speak that then Acharya is self-manifesting personality. An Acharya can never be elected by voting system. Very often Srila Prabhupada also used to speak. You know. So many things. You know. Atah Krishna Namadi no Bhavet Grajabindri, Savin Musevan Mukhehi Yuhayam Swayameva Spurtiyada. Who is not going to give me transcendental Harinama and Harikatha, how I can accept him as Guru? It is my foolishness, why I am going there to accept him. Whereas even in Archan book you can find, even in Archan book you can find one point, there is Prato Siman Navadibe Dinattan Dibujam Gurum Barabhaya Padam Santam Smareto Tannama Purvakam. In Guru Dhan, before you go for Archan, you will have to go through this procedure. You will have to meditate unto lotus feet of Guru Padma. First of all, you have to speak. Those who are pure devotees in the morning time, first day when they break their sleep, they go on speaking. Prato Siman Navadibe Dinattam Dibujam Gurum Barabhaya Padam Santam Smareto Tannama Purvakam. First of all, you will have to remember the lotus feet of your Guru Path Padma. You can concentrate into the lotus feet of Guru Path Padma. You have to do meditation. It's an automatic meditation for pure devotees. You will have to do it. So you can see that Guru Path Padma is with, you know, very nice mudra. It is Abhay Mudra. It is called Abhay Mudra. You know, he is going to make me fearless. With, you know, he is going to make me fearless. Barabhaya Padam Santam Smaretarno. Barabhaya Padam, there is no fear. I am there for you. I am there for you. Don't fear. Oh Maharaj, this material ocean is very dangerous. How to cross it? You need not play your head. I am there. I am there waiting for you. You come. Bara bhaya padam santam smareto tanna prabhukam. You will have to call Guru Path Padma with his transcendental name. Ho Guru Path Padma. Previous Raghunath Das Gosai speaking. You will have to shout day and night in the name of Guru Bhargava. Ho Raghunath Das Gosai, Ho Sanatana Gosai, Ho Rupa Gosai Path, Ho Jiva Gosai Path, please save me, Ho Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This way you have to cry. If you are not going to try, not going to cry, that's mean you are taking rest. you are feeling satisfaction in this material life. So there is no symptom that you can do bhajan. A pure Vaishnav can never feel satisfaction with his bhajan. He thinks any amount of bhajan done by him, no, I have done nothing. But dissatisfaction regarding your material enjoyment can put you in trouble. Dissatisfaction about your material enjoyment. Still today you are not satisfied with your material enjoyment. You know there is fire, you are going to jump. And now you are speaking, Maharaj, empty, my heart is empty. Foolish number one, idiot. You are making your heart empty. Who is responsible for that? Guru Vaishnava giving so much treasure to you, he cannot protect. Now you are going to blame. All empty. Huh? How it is empty? Guru Vaishnava have given you so many treasure, now it is empty because of asasanga. You are doing asasanga all the time. Asasanga, you are doing asasanga. That is why you are feeling problem. There is so much confusion going in Gaudiya society in all over the world about this acharyaship. How Prabhupada speaking this way, how it is possible that we can believe? It is not possible to elect one acharya, not possible. How we can believe? If we are not going to believe, then surely we are not going to believe Prabhupada. 25 years back, a group, a big group from one big society, you know, big society, international society, ISKCON. There Bhadracharu and others, so many devotees came in front of Guru Padma. He was that time in office. They came with this issue to ask to Guru Padma that our system of Guru Parampara, is it actually Ritik procedure? One has to elect one acharya. Otherwise, after that, who can attain an acharya? It is Ritik system. Then Guru Padma going away, and he has to make one. Guru Padma told, no, our system is not Ritik system. Apparently, you see, sometimes some problems are happening. We are somebody not going to follow the instruction of Prabhupada, that's why. But it is not actually a Ritik system. So same way, it is not Ritik system. That in the society, there is nobody whom Guru Padma can make one acharya. Still he will have to make one acharya. It is not a matter of joking. It is not a matter of joking. There is nobody found in this society whom he can make acharya. But who can run this society? Maharaj, first you are making mistake. To run a society is totally different thing. To act as an acharya is totally, you are confusing. You are confusing between these two things. To maintain a society is totally different thing. And to run a spiritual sanstha organization, loving mission of Guru Padma, exact way, as shown by Guru Padma, is quite impossible. I can give so many examples to you. So you see, who is not going to make me fearless? It is a symptom of Guru Padma. In front of him, if you reach, if you take his darshan, if you hear Harikatha, you can feel you are having tremendous power inside your heart. Tremendous power. Then you can understand 100% pure. This Harikatha is 100% pure. There is no duplicity. So first of all, there should not be any duplicity inside your heart. Genuinity should be there. Automatically, today or tomorrow, you can feel this point. Who cannot make me fearless? How he can say he is my Guru Padma? Whereas Bhaktivinoda Thakur repeatedly speaking, come on man, you should not run here and there to accept Guru Padma. Oh, I need Guru Padma. Oh, I must search here and there. What you can search? Eh? What you can search? And what you can find? by your searching procedure, by your comb operation, where you can foolish number one. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, oh man, don't try to be busy to accept Guru Padma. Wait, man, wait. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, you should not be very busy with this issue. One should not be very busy with, on this point. You know, you wait and see. If you are genuine, if there is no duplicity, automatically you are going to get divine help. Ballaji Maharaj is going to guide you. But if there is duplicity, you can accept somebody as guru who is very famous for impeaching here and there. You are blind, you cannot say anything tata, and you are going to accept a blind guru. You cannot see yourself, you are blind, spiritually blind, and you are going to accept such a man who is already blind, spiritually blind. So, andha yathandai rupaniyamanam te api sichatanta murudam nibadhya. Both of them can go to hell. Tulsidas ji also speaking so many things, I have no time to, it's a big area. I can go on discussing about what Prabhupada wanted to speak by this instruction. I can go on discussing. Vast discussion. Also you can remember, who cannot give me assurance, who cannot make me fearless, how I can accept him as guru? Guru na sasyat, na sajjano na sasyat, pita na sasyat, sajjanani na sasyat, daivam na sasyat, patim na sasyat, daivam na sasyat, namo chayedja samupeta mutyum. Who cannot save me from imminent danger, from my death coming. Who cannot take me out of the circle of death, birth and death. How I can confess that he is guru? How I can accept like a foolish that he is guru? And also I am going to add, I am Gauriya devotee. How I can believe that you are Gauriya devotee? So many conditions are there. And in also Upanishad you see, Ascharya Ashvabhakta Kushala Ashvalabdhya. Ascharya Ashvabhakta Kushala Ashvalabdhya. About that aprakita visaya, transcendental thing, very secret thing. There is no man, you cannot find even a single, you know, man, single sadhu. Rare. Not that you cannot get even a single sadhu, not the answer, it's rare. It's very rare. Ascharya asya bhaktya kusala asya labdhya. Who can speak the Harikatha? Upanishad speaking is rare. Upanishad, ascharya asya bhaktya, asya mana kasya. About Krishna. Janmadasyo yato, janmadasyo kasya, kasya, Krishnasyo. So to feel this point, all transcendental thing, fast, you will have to realize everything. If your luck is very good, very good, very good, then and only then, you can get a chance to meet with a Sadguru. And then, if your luck is good, you can realize this Sadguru, then is good. Bina Guru Bhavanidhi Tarai Na Koi, Ram Ki Paave Na Sulava Na Swai. Tulsidas just speaking. Bina guru bhava nidhi tvarai na koi. Nobody can cross this material ocean. Infinity, material ocean of Maya. Without Sadguru. But we are playing with this Guru Tattva. We are meeting, if you have any particular, if you have some prejudicial idea, sectarian attitude, please don't put this question in front of me. Don't hear this Harikatha. You cannot realize it. I am not from any party. I have no party. Nothing. Nothing. Why Sanatana Goswami told, that is the procedure of taking Diksha, that you will have to realize Bonded soul cannot realize, but still try to understand, try to feel the actual Baba of Guru Pad Padma from whom you are going to take Diksha. At least 1 year, Sanatana Goswami too. 1 year at least you will have to watch in the name of Hari Bhajan, in the name of, you know, Acharya Sip, he is doing some business or not. How you can understand? You are foolish, you have no sincerity, so both way you are going to, you know, face dangerous situation. Aschajyasya Vakta Kusalasya Labdha. Where is such a speaker who can speak about that transcendental thing out of his own realization? Who is himself going to, you know, give his whole life for this Chaitanya Vani, Guru Vani? Who is there? Who is there who can touch with Salgram, which can touch Nishinga Mandir and Nishinga Dev and speak that I only want Krishna, I want nothing? Who can speak? Who? Who can speak this way? Who can touch Salgram, can develop Kushta leprosy in hand? Who can touch that kind of audacity? Who can show? Eh? Only their cell phone, only their cell phone, only their cell phone is sufficient to expose their dirty character. Only their cell phone. What they are doing, what they are talking, what they are doing, only this, nothing else. Only their cell phone can expose what they are discussing, what they are doing. Oh, you know, past 1 year, or no year, 1 year, 6 months, or even 1 month, even 15 days, even 1 week, what kind of discussion they are doing over telephone, cell phone. This can expose. So why you are fighting, why you are coming to meet with fighting mood? Whereas I am approaching with very humble mood to discuss this point. I have no jealousy, nothing. I like to point out you are blind. I like to open your eyes and try to see there is sunrise. Like one owl, there is sunrise, but owl cannot see. An owl cannot see, is blind in daytime. Nighttime you can see, that owl can see. That's why Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is going to compare this thing. We are all like owl. There is so much tattva represented by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Guru Varga, immense treasure. Who is going to understand, who is going to feel, who is having that kind of patience? No patience, like monkey, like chanchal monkey, jumping from this branch to that branch. No time. What time you have? Eh? What time you have in your life? You have no time to hear about this, you know, Prakita Tattva. You like to keep, you know, silence. You know, you are, sometime you understand. You like to keep, you know, Tum bishu, hum bishu. Arey Maharaj, you should keep silence. I can also keep silence. Mutual understanding. Tum bichu, bham bichu. Prabhupada never wanted to approve this kind of mood. Prabhupada never approved this kind of mood. Because, you know, how to understand, how to feel this point. Andha yathande rupaniyama. How you can say that this is my Guru Pad Padma? You are running blindly. Maharaj, 10,000 disciples there. You know, that's why you are going. But Guru Tattva is not such a cheap tattva that you can realize very easily. So, who cannot make me fearless? Who cannot make me fearless? Who cannot save me from my imminent danger? Who cannot take me out of this my cycle infinite, for infinity pure birth and death circle? Who cannot stop me? How I can say he is Guru? Why Sanatana Goswami told that 1 year at least you will have to wait and watch in the name of Acharya, if he is doing any business or not. What is the intention? Jivedaya Krishna Nam Sarvadharma Sar. Those who are pure sadhu, they are so merciful, so merciful, so merciful. Even in dream, you cannot realize. Even in dream, it's not possible for you to understand. All the time they are like to save you. You are blind. They like to open your eyes and watch what is happening all around the world. All the time they are going to, speak all about their absolute truth. So asyajya asya bhakta kusala asya labdhya. That kind of speaker from whom we can, under whom we can expect all transcendental truth, absolute truth, is rare. Asyajya asya bhakta is very unique. Such a speaker who can speak all about the transcendental things out of his own feeling is rare. And still rare, still rare. It is rare, I know, but still rare. Who can accept this absolute truth? Ashyajya Shabakta Kushala Salabha, who can accept? Who can accept? Who? Who can accept? Can you show? So maybe you can get some guru by chance. Whereas Tulsidas is speaking, without mercy of Bhagavan, you cannot get guru. You know, Sanatan, actually, Rupa Goswami is speaking, Jiva Goswami is also speaking, actually discussing in Sandarbha. The preliminary satsanga, preliminary satsanga can help you to understand your poor condition of heart. Satsanga, you can go, it's called Savan Guru. After that, hearing Harikatha from a pure Vaishnava, you must feel it very urgent to take shelter of a Sadguru. If you are not going to feel any urgency to take shelter of a Sadguru, then surely you are not actually not doing Satsanga. Surely you are not doing Satsanga. The result of Satsanga is 100%. The result of Satsanga is that you must feel it very urgent to take shelter of a Sadguru. It's a must. You know, you can do Satsanga here, Harikatha, you cannot feel it. It cannot so happen. Shankar Bhagavan many times told, Shankar Bhagavan told in form of Devi, Mahamaya Devi, Ho Devi, Gurabo Bhavo Sundi, Shisho Vittapaharakaha, Durlabo Sadguru Devi, Shisho Santapaharakaha. O Devi, there is countless Guru. Countless. There is no, the market is open. There is countless Guru. Everybody, who not, everybody like to act as Guru. Nobody want to become Shisho. Everybody like to become Guru. Everybody, who not? Everybody like to become Guru. But nobody like to become Shishya. So in infinity period, they can never become Guru. They all want to become Guru. Never they like to become Shishya. They never. So Guru Bho Bhavo Shanti Shishya Vittapaharaka Durlabo Guru Devi Shisho Santapaharaka. It is almost rare, such Guru, who can erase all painful experience from the heart of a disciple. Jahara Nikate Gile Pab Dure Jai. You know, it's not a matter of joking. Narottama Thakur speaking everything out of his own feeling. Yahara nikate gele pab dure jaye, emono dayal prabhu keba kotha pay. You know, we can sing, but we cannot feel. in front of pure Guru Vaishnava, if you come, you can feel some reaction inside your heart. Even if they are not speaking anything, if you look at them, even if you look at them, you can feel some reaction inside your heart. Surely, you can feel some reaction inside your heart, something happening inside your heart. You know, Binu Guru, Bhavanidhi, Taraina Koi, Rama Kipavi Nusunava Sulavanase, Binu Sato Sanga, Taraina Koi, Ram Kipabinu Sulabonasai, Ram Kipabinu Sulabonasai. It's not possible. First preliminary, you must show your sincerity. Balaji Maharaj helping you preliminary. After that, when you are feeling, you know, is getting inspiration to get shelter unto the lotus feet of Sadguru, then again Balaji Maharaj can help you. I can discuss all this tattva on Balaji Maharaj Abhirbhav Tithi, if he bless me. So, anyway, Balaji Maharaj is going to help us to get back our consciousness, helping as Guru, Vaishnava all the time. You know, so Sadguru is how you can, so Asrajya Sabhakta Kusala Salabdha. Even if you are going to search the whole world, combo operation, maybe you can get one or two in this world, who is just powerful to speak about the transcendental word, about that transcendental word, from his direct feeling, he can speak Harikatha. Maybe, but can you point out one who is a genuine, who is going to hear perfectly? Kushala Salabdha. Who can catch? Who can digest? Who can catch? Who can catch? Who can digest? Who can follow Guru Padma in toto? Can you show? Can you show me one instance? Who can follow Guru Padma? Because it's an automatic factor. Snigdhasya Sishyasya Guru Gujhyam Apiyoto. If he is not Snigdhasya Sishya, automatically he is not going to enjoy full kipa of Guru Padma. Out of some politics, he can take the asan of Guru Padma. That is not actually Guru Tattva. So, you see, many slokas we will have to arrange. Many slokas we will have to. Achajyor arani raddo antevasi uttar arani. Many, many slokas from Bhagavad Upanishad, so many. Still, if you cannot believe me, then your luck is very bad. What to do? Who cannot give me direct feeling about their aprakita tattva, who cannot save me from my imminent danger, I cannot accept him as Guru. Jai Krishna Tattvavetta Sai Guru Hoy, who is having full Krishna Tattvavetta, who is knowing all details about Krishna tattva, direct realization. That's why about Guru tattva many times we are bound to speak. Jayat, about Shabde Parecha Nishnatam, Shabda Brahma and Parabrahma. And Shabda Brahma, if you are Nishnata, you are having total, you know, about Siddhanta Tattva, everything. Shabde Parecha Nishnatam, Parabrahma also. Parabrahma Nishnatam means through Seva. What I can expect from Sadguru? What I can expect from Sadguru? What I can expect from Sadguru? That Sadguru can make me Acharya, next Acharya, idiot number one. Sadguru can make me next Acharya. I am businessman, I am pros. What I can expect from Guru Padma? The direct feeling that Guru Maharaj have inside his heart about Seva. That a snigdha sishya can expect from Guru Padma. What we can expect from Sadguru? The Sadguru can give me direct feeling of that seva. Feeling of seva. Guru Padma enjoying seva all the time, non-stop. Prabhupada speaking, the symptom of a Guru Padma is his unique acharyaship, is his unique seva mood. His unique seva mood, Prabhupada speaking. How we can understand? By watching his seva mood, his siddhanta. You can automatically understand. Prabhupada speaking, phalena phalakaranam animiyate. Are you will have to watch fruits. What kind of fruits is there? Everybody going to give garlands, everything, wash your lotus feet. Okay. But you are so blind, you are not going to follow. We are going to not going to see that Siddhanta Bichar, what kind of books he is writing, all wrong. Siddhanta. What kind of Siddhanta is speaking in Harikatha? All wrong. But still, whole world running behind him. How we can save him? How we can save you? They are blind. They don't understand this point. That he already, you know, Sadguru. Sadguru, and how we can understand this Sadguru? How we can understand? We have to follow, he is following his Guru Padma, his Siddhanta, Vichar, all everything coming inside the heart of present Acharya or not. If present Acharya is devoid of all these things, Kripa, then maybe he is elected Acharya, still he is not Acharya. Still, you can go and commit suicide unto his lotus feet, but it concerns to me. It is not Acharya. Prabhupada speaking this symptom, if you find all reflected inside the heart of Satsisya, all the Siddhanta Vichar, all etiquette, all everything, totally, you can find inside the heart of present Acharya. Then, is Sadguru. He is also Sadguru. This way we will have to understand, otherwise big problem. So, it is almost rare. It is almost rare at present. It is almost rare at present whom we can believe 100%. Whom we can believe 100%, that's why. Baladev Vidyabhusan also, in Prameya Ratnavali here, there are so many is writing that if Guru Parampara, I mean Mantra Parampara, is not intact, if there is some breakage, then you are going to lose your power. Same flow or power you cannot expect. If there is breakage of linkage, like I am giving example, like my Guru Padma giving me instruction, you go and get some Ganga water I need. If I go to South India, you know, to show, you know, and I am getting water from some river, it is not Ganga. To get Ganga water, I will have to go in such a place where I can find Ganga flowing that way. Then I can get Ganga water. If Ganga water is not there, it's contaminated. It's a big problem. Similarly, Sampradaya vihina je mantraha asti nishphala mataha. I can discuss this point next day maybe. Not today, not possible. So, we are going to give some example about how a Sampradaya flow become blind. That's why Prabhupada wanted to show us, Baladev Vidyavasan already told, that if Mantra Parampara going to get disrupted, some problem there, then you can find some breakage in Mantra Parampara. Then you cannot get power. In that case, big problem. What to do? That's why Prabhupada, in his Guru Parampara, he was bound to write this way. Krishna hoite chaturmukh, hai Krishna sevanmukh, Brahma hoite narodero moti, narodo hoite vyas, maddo kahe vyasodasa, punabhugga paddunavu. This way actually, Prabhupada wanted to show us that Mantra Parampara and Bhagavat Parampara should be harmonized. You can remember Mahaprabhu in Chaitanya Charitamrita speaking, Pancharatik procedure is all the same with that, you know, that Agam Nigam already I told, is all the same. Pancharatik procedure not separate, ultimately meaning same. You know, Mahaprabhu already told. Now, why Prabhupada wanted to make a big, very, very nice, Prabhupada wanted to make, wanted to give a big, nice harmony between this Mantra Parampara and Bhagavata Parampara. Because it is impractical. It is most impractical, a matter, to think that I can get my Mantra Parampara intact. Okay, maybe thousands of years going on. No, not possible. Not possible. There can be some breakage. I am not saying 100% breakage. There can be some breakage. From Prabhupada, you know, from Gaur Kishore Baba, and before, already I published, I wrote one book long ago. I will have to revise this book and give more examples. And in Gauriya, in Saraswat Gauriya Sampradaya, is there no Guru Parampara? I already wrote maybe 12 years back. I will have to revise it and publish it again. There I give. So, also you can, there you can find the parampara, our Gauriya Parampara, Gaur Kishore Baba, before Gaur Kishore Baba, who Mantra Parampara. And after that, Prabhupada wanted to show us how it is possible to maintain the, harmonize the Bhagavad Parampara and Mantra Parampara. If it is not harmonized, then big problem can be there. That's why Prabhupada wanted to make Krishna ite chaturmukh hai Krishna sevanmukh Brahma ite narade ramati narade hoite vyasa madhukahe vyasudat purna bhagya padunabhamot. This way you can go. After that you can Mahaprabhu Sri Chaitanya Radha Krishna nahe anno Rupanuga janare juvan. That from there you can find Bhagavad Parampara. 100% scientific procedure. 100% scientific. This way, Bhagavad Parampara is so practical, that you cannot ignore it. You know, you cannot ignore it. Even in our sampradaya, I can point out so many Mayavadis. They are not going to believe that we are in the line of Madhvacharya. They are, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, they are all Mayavadi. They are not at all Gauriya Bhakta. They can take sannyas, they cannot take sannyas. It's up to them. But anyway, we are not going to confess. Total system so corrupted. How to rectify it? To change the conception of common people is very dangerous. They are so much biased. They are so much prejudicial conception there. It is almost impossible to change their conception.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Acharya mam bijaniyat navamannet karichit.
Acharya mam bijaniyat. Actually, this point is so sensitive point. It is a point of our survival in the way of our bhajan life. This is not so cheap issue that we can start fighting on this point. So, Acharya Mang Bijaniyat, Krishna Bhagavan speaking, in front of Buddha, I can discuss this point next day. Now today I like to point out something to you. What Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur told. Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur was very, you know, practical over this point, all the time. No cheap sentiment. The bad name attributed due to the Vaishnavas, due to the deviation of the renunciates. Those who are in renounce order, and you know, some group are there, they are going to do all rubbish thing. That's why whole sampradaya is going to get some bad name. This is there is lot of slander against the renounced order because of the faults of certain class of renunciates. It is my desire, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is my desire that the pure Vaishnavas renounce, those who are fallen, and give proper exemplary instruction for the world. They should renounce those. The number of those false renunciates are gradually increasing, and the time has come to completely isolate ourselves from them, Bhaktivinoda Thakur told. Most renunciates is under the spell of Kali. The devotee who is in renounced order is rare. The reason is, unless a person gives up all material desires and with good behavior engages in chanting the holy name constantly, only then will he be able to maintain his purity. Then and only then, if he is going to practice pure Harinam, pure way, you know, all maintaining all rules and regulation, Vaishnava legacy. Hence, when the number of renounced people seem to keep increasing, this means it is the evil work of Kali. The other reason for this increase is that whether the person is suitable or not is not considered. He is suitable before giving sannyas to anybody, nobody going to judge. He is capable, he can maintain, you know. This is the main problem. That's why we are going to get bad result, you know. A fallen sannyasas can no way take up the robe of a sannyasi, as that will tantamount to hypocrisy. But who is going to pass judgment? I can discuss this in 2 days disturbance. I can discuss this point tomorrow in details. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking that only to fight with each other, make fighting over some issue, is not the duty of an acharya. Gauriya Sampradaya, the acharya, those who are sitting in acharya asana, it is their main duty to eliminate all anartha, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. It is their main duty to eliminate all anartha of the sampradaya. But we are going to give some extra advantage. You know, we are going to, like, you know, I told you, know, those who are, you know, terrorist, some groups, they are going to give them facility. You stay here, I can give you facility. So, this way actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is the main duty of those who are acting as acharya and Gauri Sampradaya to eliminate all anartha of the Sampradaya. If they cannot do, they cannot come out successful. Because Sampradaya, how you can give full protection to Sampradaya? Only through the maintenance of Amnai Bani, Shuddha Bani, Amnai, Parampara, Bani Vaibhav. If you can give full protection to Siddhanta Bani, then and only then it is possible for you to give full protection to Siddhanta. Otherwise, not possible. This way, it is, and at present, it is a really critical task, almost impossible. Vaishnava etiquette, what is the situation going on? Who can rectify whom? Who can rectify whom? Everybody is full of false ego. Nobody can rectify. This is the situation. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. And so many Siddhanta beaches there in Hayasis Pancharatra, I can discuss tomorrow. And Matsapuran, Puran, Bayu Puran, so many. You know, Acharya, whom we can say Acharya, how at the character of Acharya, all in details, you know, we can discuss tomorrow, actually. Now I can give one example from Ramayana. One example from Ramayana. I heard it from Guru Bhargava. You know. In Ramayana, there is one incident that a pet dog was beaten by master heavily without any reason. After being beaten by master heavily, very often, not that one day, every day, after being beaten heavily by master, you know, ultimately the dog took decision to approach Sri Ramchandra. It is the case and at that time actually, Sri Ram Bhagavan, Ramchandra, for justice. Why my master going to beat me unnecessarily? After apprising all the facts in front of Sri Ramchandra, the dog was expecting, waiting to get reply from Ramchandra for justice. He was expecting justice. Sri Ramchandra, you know, the Supreme Lord, a symbol of justice. So nobody can expect anything unusual from him. Ultimately, Sri Ramchandra wanted to ask the dog that what kind of punishment you think fit for him? What kind of punishment you think fit for him? The dog immediately started speaking, replied that, Prabhu, could you please make him Acharya of that temple society? Could you please make him Acharya of that? Why? Why you are speaking? Because the dog speaking replied, I myself was an Acharya of that society in my previous life. It's very, very sensitive post. If you make problem, make aparad, big punishment you will have to get. Because all in the society, whatever wrong going on, you know, all Acharya have to take responsibility. The dog replied that I myself was the Acharya of that society. Could you please make him Acharya of the temple, the society? It was one kind of punishment. I am not going to criticize it. Now I can go on explaining what is the bhava, what is the mood of Prabhupada. Then now I can clear. Tomorrow I can discuss all in details. To run a society and to run a Prakita Gauriya Math is not one and the same, not same. To run a society and to run a Prakita Gauriya Math can never be one and the same. It's not same. Srila Prabhupada and Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you'll have to run a Gauriya Math, you will have to follow in Srila Prabhupada and Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur in toto. To run a Gauriya Math, you will have to follow Srila Prabhupada and Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur in toto. No compromise can be there. Toto you will have to follow. At present, who is interested to run Gauriya Math in that way? That is the main question.